Welcome back, guys, to another NEO video. So far, stock today, November 6th, isn't really doing so well. But hey, I mean, negative 2.7%, it's not even that bad considering that the stock has been on a constant moon mission. And a small little break like this is honestly pretty normal. I'm holding some calls long term. I'm not really too scared about it. And today, at one point, we were down more than 5%. Now, that's pretty scary. And during pre-market, at one point, we're down 8%. So this recovery is actually not that bad. Today, there's a pretty big event that's causing a lot of drastic changes in the stock, which is Battery Day. Keep in mind that NIO's Battery Day is giving us all a deja vu moment. Remember when Tesla announced the Battery Day? Stock was soaring before Battery Day. And on Battery Day, everyone sold off their shares and the stock absolutely plummeted. That's with Tesla. NIO, same thing. I gotta give myself a mental check next time not to buy calls the day before Battery Day. Even though my portfolio, it's doing pretty good for Robinhood, I don't really care that much. It's kind of like a YOLO account. I feel like NIO is a pretty good stock to hold long term. I feel like next week we should definitely be seeing a major surge once again. NIO, it's kind of needing a pullback. I guess today's a pretty decent pullback, especially when the stock dropped negative 5%. All the people that want to take profits, all the short-term traders already sold their shares, and we saw this huge amount of buying right here. And keep on the NIO stock every single day has record amounts of volume. And honestly though, negative 2.7% really isn't that bad considering the stock is up nearly 100% in the past month. One of the biggest things about today is the NIO 100 kilowatt hour battery launch event. This is a super big deal that I will be getting into. Now, if you check out the press release, they talked about the 100 kilowatt hour battery and flexible battery plans. Now, this battery is pretty insane. It's a 100 kilowatt hour battery, and it should give a NIO SUV roughly 370 miles per charge. That's pretty good considering that the NIO SUVs and the NIO cars that they make are super big cars. If you check out, for example, the ES8, this is not a small Tesla Model 3. This is not a Tesla Model X. This is legit a giant electric Range Rover looking car. It's actually pretty big with all of the stuff on it. The lithium ion battery needs to perform a lot of work. Same thing with the ES6. This is also a giant SUV that a lot of people seem to like. And the EC6, even though it's a crossover, it's still pretty decently big. So with these giant SUV cars traveling 370-ish miles per charge, it's pretty impressive, especially the Porsche Taycan, for example, only could run at 180 to 220 miles per charge. And most EV companies can't even reach above 250 miles per charge. So NIO coming out with 370 miles per charge makes it more of a battery company than anything else. Hold up, did I just say that NIO was kind of like a battery company? NIO is actually a software company, a battery company, AI company, and a car manufacturer that only makes electric vehicles. Now, what I just said right there was very similar to Tesla's business model. Tesla makes EVs. Tesla also does autopilot. They also research batteries. NIO, same exact thing. They're trying to pride themselves as a luxury brand on top of that. And the market cap, it's only $40 billion. Tesla's market cap is $400 billion. I feel like NIO should definitely get even more recognition because they're doing really well. On top of that, speaking of this battery, if you guys have a NIO car, for example, it's either gonna be 70 kilowatt hour battery or a 84 kilowatt hour battery. And you could actually opt in, you could tell NIO that you want to upgrade it to the 100 kilowatt battery. You don't actually have to buy a completely new car. You just pay like a small fee and they'll actually upgrade your battery to this brand new one, which is actually kind of dope that you don't actually have to buy a whole entire new battery. There's also battery as a service, which not even Tesla has this feature. No other car manufacturer in the world has this. NIO says that they already installed hundreds of these battery swapping stations around China and have performed more than a million battery swaps. And a million is higher than 800,000 battery swaps a few months ago when they talked about it. This is actually the thing that made Bank of America super bullish on NIO. Battery as a service or battery swapping technology is pretty awesome since you could opt in to not purchase the battery and get $10,000 off your NIO car, but you have to pay a subscription fee of $140 per month. I don't really care too much about it. Honestly though, it's actually really beneficial for both the consumer and NIO, they both make a bunch of money and they save a bunch of money. It's actually pretty nice. And so far, this battery swapping technology is insane. Swaps your battery out with a freshly new charged 100% battery in less than 3 minutes. Charging your battery usually takes about 30 to 40 minutes and it only charges up to 80%. That's the downside of charging, but battery swap takes things to a whole new level. People complained about electric vehicles for two things: not enough range. Well, NIO is delivering the 100 kilowatt hour battery. Second, charging takes too long, whereas a gasoline car, you could fill up a whole tank in less than a few minutes. Well, NIO also fixed that solution with battery swap technology, which swaps out your battery in less than 3 minutes. So the two major things that people complain about electric vehicles just got solved by NIO in a single event, which is pretty bullish in my opinion. So I feel like the stock in the long term should definitely do pretty decent. And on top of that, you got Elon Musk pretty much saying that NIO is a pretty decently big competitor, making a pretty big jab at NIO's stock price. 420 is 10 times better than 42. 420 pretty much meaning that Tesla stock is around $420-ish. NIO stock is roughly at $42, and saying that Tesla is better than NIO, making small and playful jabs and, of course, fueling even more competition. Keep in mind, the NIO CEO and founder has said this before. NIO, being a six-year-old car company, was actually better than when Tesla was a six-year-old company. So there's like this little friendly competition going on in China. Tesla, NIO, these two really big giants fighting each other for market share. NIO even came out with their EC6, which is this crossover, and they're already selling these crossovers, whereas Tesla's Model Y is still under production. So you can kind of get the idea. Competition is honestly getting fierce, and I'm all down for some competition. This really does promote a lot of really, really big products coming out from both companies. More competition there is, the harder both companies will work. There's also several price targets that I want to talk about. One of them is City Analyst raising the price target from $33 to $46. That is an insane price target from Citi. Remember, big banks, big hedge funds are extremely conservative with their price targets. They're not going to be giving you guys a really, really good price target usually. It's usually very conservative. But keep in mind, 33 to 46 is not a conservative price target, meaning Citi is super bullish on it. Like, I haven't seen Citi been this bullish ever, honestly. And then you got HSBC raising the price target to $30. You also have JP Morgan Chase several weeks ago raising it to $40, which NIO already beat. And then you also have JP Morgan Chase pretty much kickstarting this giant frenzy of buying for a lot of EV shares in the Chinese car manufacturer industry. Bank of America is bullish. Morgan Stanley is pretty bullish. Deutsche Bank upgraded to $34. Deutsche Bank is bullish. Everyone seems to love NIO stock. But of course, always keep in mind that NIO and the overall 100 kilowatt hour battery launch event is a really, really big deal. You can't sleep on this. NIO stock is honestly pretty nice. Now, don't forget that NIO with the overall launch event did some pretty incredible stuff. Announcing battery as a service is pretty incredible. They also introduced a brand new 100 kilowatt hour battery and addressing several issues. Like, some people don't like electric vehicles because of the low range. They somewhat fixed that and given out a car battery that's 370 miles. People also complain, hey, gasoline cars, you can fill up the tank in less than 2 minutes. Electric cars, it takes like almost an hour to charge through 100%. Well, NIO also someone fixed this and also talking about improvements and also their battery swapping stations, which they will open up more in China. I can't wait to see NIO in other countries. For example, maybe Australia, maybe some places in Europe, maybe North America would be pretty cool, because so far their business model is pretty good and coming out with a lot of innovative stuff that not even Tesla has. Thanks for watching, guys, and comment below.